please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
For all these questions and for, of course, the ubiquitous GST question, HM Bharuka, Vice Chairman and Managing Director of Kansai Nerolac, joins us. Good morning, Mr. Bharuka. Thank you very much for joining us. First up, just lay out the demand scenario for us. Is it looking good because consumption has picked up across the board? So is the scenario giving you the confidence that even if raw material is expensive, you can push on the prices upper?
Good morning, Lata, Sonia and Anuj. I think you put it rightly. Yes, scenario for the top line is looking good. And I think we have been always saying that paint industry is going to have a double-digit growth. So that growth story continues. And we hope in this election year, when the government spends more on the rural economy, the consumption goes up further. And if we hope GST rates are reduced further, then this will also give a boost to the paint industry. So I think overall we see a lot of positivity as far as volume growth is concerned, but concern do remain on the bottom line.
Okay. Mr. Bharuka, good morning. That actually was my next question, because there was quite a bit of pressure on your margins in FY18. You think that would be under further pressure, or it could improve from here?
Anuj, very difficult to answer this question for simple reason, because we are seeing a lot of volatility in the crude oil prices, the rupee getting depreciated, and with geopolitical situation, with interest rate rising in US, and fiscal deficit perhaps going to become higher. So all these are complications which actually points out toward a very volatile situation. So it makes it difficult for the industry like us when we deal with B2B. How do we approach our customers? And we have to be very, very fair to our customer. We do understand our costs have gone up. We need to pass it on to them. But at the same time, how do we approach them? And we have a contract with our customer. So we don't look at our customer on a very short-term perspective. We look at them from a long-term perspective. Some of the customers, right from the day one, we have been supplying to them. So for us, those relationships are more important than, protecting a short-term profit. So I think if you look from a long-term horizon, there would be a possibility in short-term we may have a dip in profit. But in the long horizon, I think if you are able to protect our top line, we should be able to get back our margin.
So when you say double-digit growth outlook, just coming back to the first statement you made, I mean, double-digit could be 10%, it could be 20%. So are you looking at the higher end? I mean, will it be closer to 20% given that the last few quarters have looked good?
Sonia, I think 20% is too high as of now to expect. But even if we get mid double-digit growth between that, I think that should be a good double-digit growth given the scenario of last year and the turmoil which everyone is facing. So I think in that scenario, double-digit growth, volume growth, if we get even 12% to 14%, especially on the decorative side, I think that should be a good double-digit growth. On the industrial side, of course, we expect some slowdown in the automotive sector. And we feel that growth should be actually a single-digit growth, not a double-digit growth.
Why do you say that, Mr. Bharuka? Because we just got the June auto numbers. They looked very strong. I mean, reasonably strong. You sensing this momentum can't continue?
I think we are looking, June numbers year on year, where last year GST was introduced and the base was very, very low. Mm-hmm. But if you look on month from May to June, actually there is almost 12% to 15% down compared to the May. And my personal feeling is, auto number would be slightly under consolidation phase going forward, except for two-wheeler, which is because of the rural economy may do well. But otherwise, there's a possibility there could be some slowdown in the auto sector. That is my personal feeling. However, I may be wrong, and I will be happy if I am wrong.
Okay. Well, I wanted to ask you about the GST scenario, sir. What is the distribution arm? I mean, there was a bit of disruption for especially FMCG companies, maybe not paints. Has that disruption of distribution gotten sorted out? But more importantly, has it given you any extra market share because informal sector is not able to cope with GST?
I think GST, you rightly said, paint industry was not much affected except at the distribution level where there were a lot of confusion for the dealer, the administration problem. But I think credit goes to the government. They handled it very well. And from a monthly return, they have made it to a quarterly return. And now they are talking about yearly return. And the way I am seeing government moving on this administration side, it gives me a lot of confidence. You will have to wait for one more year to get it stabilized. And when the invoice matching starts, and that is where the benefit of, you know, from unorganized to organized sector would come in. As of now, I don't see much benefit coming in, but maybe part of unorganized sector is becoming a formalized economy, and which is a good for the entire country. So right now, the collection which you are seeing about 95,000 crores, I mean, we expect it to go up to about 20 to 25%, but not in this year, maybe next year.
Okay, you know, you had spoken about the big growth in the decorative paint segment the last time we spoke to you. From this 12% market share, I think, that you're currently sitting at, how much do you think your market share could increase in decorative paints over the next 1 to 2 years?
So, it's difficult for me to speak from a market share perspective because I don't know how other players are doing and how market shares are calculated by the player. So, it is difficult for me to say. So, as far as we are concerned, we just look at how are we doing ourselves. And we feel we are doing pretty well. Now, how much increase in market share that is leading to, I think we have a very low base. And even if 2% extra growth I get, it is not going to lead much change in the market share, except that our ratio of decorative and industrial become more favorable, which will help us in protecting our bottom line.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, let me just come back to that one point you said about auto sales numbers in June, and you correctly pointing out that it's not as good as May. This could also be seasonal. May has more number of working days. June gets disrupted by rain. I mean, you would know better. Just give us a little more color on how you are looking at growth. I mean, in terms of demand and the automotive sector.
I think on a passenger vehicle, we look at a growth of about 5 to 7%, 5% on a lower side, 7% on a higher side, and two-wheeler could be about 10 to 12%. And given the push in the rural economy, provided monsoon is very good, then we can see a tractor sale continue to grow very well. And commercial vehicle segment may come slightly under pressure this time, so because it's, I think, base has become slightly better. So overall, if you put apple and oranges together, we look at 8 to 9% growth on the auto side.
All right. Mr. Bharuka, it's always a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you very much for assessing so many pieces for us, the GST piece, the margin piece, and giving us your idea of how growth is headed in the automotive space.